Hey everyone, my name is Zoe and you are watching another episode of X Marks the News. Without a doubt, the biggest news for today's episode is about the Starladder Season 9 finals in Kiev, where many of the top contenders for TI4 were battling for a prize pool of over $200,000. And the group stage came to a close with DK topping out of Group A, while EG came swinging out of the gate going 3-0 in Group B. DK continued to dominate in the playoffs, cruising into the grand finals without dropping a single game. And in the losers bracket, Empire went on the most impressive run, beating Rock's Kiss, Alliance, IG, and then even Evil Geniuses 2-1 in order to progress into the grand finals to face DK. And despite Empire's tenacity, they were no match for Team DK, who took two quick games off Empire in order to secure the title and $85,000. And if you missed the matches, many of our writers from joinDOTA.com did an excellent job doing write-ups for each key match. Shortly before Starladder, the MLG TKO commenced with the finals of its European division between Fnatic and Team Empire. And for the first place, a prize of $40,000, the two teams came out swinging in an action-packed series that featured a myriad of different drafts. Despite Empire being used to the carnage and bloodshed that comes with being one of the best in the CIS scene, they ended up losing to Fnatic in a 3-1 manner. The Dota 2 Champions League finally came to a close last week as well, with Cloud9 facing Na'Vi in the best of 5 finals. Na'Vi managed to take the first game in the series with an impressive performance with Dandy's Invoker. However, Cloud9 struck back in game 2 with their classic Visage and Draw Ranger combination. After a tough loss in game 3, Cloud9 seemed to fall apart, quickly losing the last game of the night and taking second place prize of $31,000, while Na'Vi went home with gold and $62,000 in their pockets. An interesting turn occurred in the Fragbite Masters Tournament when Team Dog faced 4FC and made history together by having the match that stretched over 125 minutes. With over 140 kills and over 2 hours of playtime, this is the longest competitive match in history of Dota 2. And for all who have missed it, we have a write-up and a link to the highlights in the comments below and over at joinDOTA.com. Last week, we told you about the gossip and rumors surrounding the various roster changes for some of the teams as they settle in for the upcoming TI4 qualifiers. And we now have confirmation that Demon will be joining Team Liquid as their 5th, replacing Fluff and Stuff after his blogging incident. While more of the JDL playoff matches have yet to be played, the 3rd GIGABYTE challenge is already on the way and will continue tonight. So be sure to tune in to watch some of the best up-and-coming teams battle it out for a $2,000 prize pool. And with this, we are coming to the end of this episode. I want to thank you all for watching and I hope to see you again next week.